There has been no activity at 29 Violet Avenue in Waterville for several days. This is where Ayla Reynolds was last seen, reported missing by her father, Justin DePietro. Saturday, December 17th, DePietro said he last saw his daughter the night before, and when he awoke in the morning, she was gone. DePietro saying his daughter must have been snatched from her bed. Now police saying the abduction theory is not plausible.
We don't know what happened at this point. We don't have the full story. What we do know is that she did not walk out of that house alone. We dispelled that on week two, and we have grave doubts that she was abducted.
In the early days of the investigation, detectives collected hundreds of pieces of potential evidence from the home, including blood in the basement. News 8 first reported last night that blood was Ayla's. Police wouldn't say how much blood they found or if they believe the toddler is dead.
We still hold our hope that this little girl is alive. But we can tell you that as the days turn into weeks, our concern grows, but we are still hopeful that we'll find her.
Police are now confirming who was in the house and where they slept. DePietro with his girlfriend and her child slept in a room in the basement. DePietro's sister and her child were in a bedroom on the main floor, and Ayla was in another bedroom on the main floor all by herself.
We think that those three individuals know more than they're telling us.
Are they lying?
I'm telling you that they're not telling us the full story.
Over the weekend, for the first time appearing in public together, Ayla's mother and father during a vigil in Waterville. Trista Reynolds and Justin DePietro embrace. He refused to answer any questions about the blood found.
My reaction is I'm still trying to concept the fact that blood was found of my daughters. That's my reaction. Okay? Yeah.